This conference will now be recorded.
Okay, let's start. Yeah, so we are discussing this interactive classical reporting. Now, see here, I gave the customer range like this. I'm using a different server now. I gave the customer range as 1000 to 1010. Okay, I gave the customer range as 1000 to 1010. Okay, and rest of the part is same. So when I execute, okay, when I execute, I got the customer data. If I click on 1004, no sales orders for the selected customer. I think it's audible to everyone. Is it audible? Hello, is it audible? Okay, fine. Right. So when I double click on this 1005, I got the message, no sales orders for the selected customer. I'll double click on 1002. I got the sales orders. Now yesterday, we were discussing one point. So when I'm displaying this customer data, for the customer number field, how much width I'm reserving? 20 character space I'm reserving. 20 character space I'm reserving. Since I'm reserving 20 character space, okay, when I'm extracting the customer number from the selected line, we are saying 0 of 20. Starting from the index 0, extract what 20 characters. Okay. So if you are not reserving any space, the default width of customer is what? Character of what? 10. Okay. So just see here. Let me check whether I can show it in this server. So as of now, I'm extracting how many characters? 20 characters, because while displaying also I reserve 20 character space. So when I execute, when I double click on 1002, yes, I got the sales orders. For 1002, I'm having the sales orders. Okay, keep that in mind. I'll double click on 1001, I got the different sales orders. I'll double click on 1000, I got different sales orders. When I double click on 1004, there are no sales orders, but 1000, 1001 and 1002 customers has got what? Sales orders. Has got sales orders. Now what is the change I'll do is, I'll give it as 0 of 10. Why 0 of 10? Because in the database also, the width of the customer is character of 10. So when I execute this, let's see whether we'll get the data or not. Now I'll double click on 1005. Yes, obviously 1005 doesn't have any sales orders. Now I'll double click on 1002. Oh, I'm getting the data now. I'll double click on 1001, I'm getting the data. I'll double click on 1000, I'm getting the data. Here also I'm getting a. One second. Achcha, okay, because I'm doing this one. Okay, let me just comment this part. Yeah, now see the issue. Right, so now I'll double click on 1002. Yes, what happened? No sales orders for the selected customer. I'll double click on 1001. No sales orders for the selected customer. Okay, so see the point here. When I execute, yeah, I'll double click on 1002. So if you see SY-LISCL, it contains what? Content of the entire line. It contains the content of the entire line. So what we are trying to do, we are trying to extract the customer number. So what I said here, from the SY-LISCL, starting from the index 0, extract how many number of characters? 10 characters. Extract what? 10 characters. So when I say FI, then I got 1002. So the customer number is what? 1002. Okay. So if you observe the table, let me go to, if I go to VBAK table, let me open the table. Yeah, in this table, if I go to the contents, yeah, sold to party, I'll give 1002. Yeah, I'm not interested in the other fields, so I'll just say format list, choose fields. I'll deselect everything. Let me select only Weblen, and I'll select what customer number. Okay, let me search for that. So when 1002 I'm getting, when I execute, yeah, you can see here 1002 is prefixed with how many zeros? 6 zeros, because the overall width of customer is what character of what 10. So here what I'm doing here, as of now V underscore Kunnar is 1002, but in the table it is stored as what? It is stored as 6 zeros and 1002. So when I say FI, I'm getting the sales orders, right? So if you see this, when I say FI, what happened? My select statement is failed. Size sub RC is what? 4. Size sub RC is 4. I didn't got the data. I didn't got the data. So what I have done here. Where is that? Yeah. Here what I have to do? I have to use either unpack function or I have to use that particular function model. So when I say unpack here, done. So again, see here, I'll put the breakpoint 1002. I'll double click. So as of now, V underscore Kunnar is 1002. Now, if it is not initial, right, I'll say FI, done. I'm using unpack function. What is the width of this V underscore Kunnar? V underscore Kunnar is type KNA1-Kunnar, which is character of 10. So it is going to suffix 6 zeros for this particular customer number. When I say FI, I got 1002. Now when I execute the select query, size of RC is 0. I got how many sales orders? 104 sales orders. I'm displaying it. Okay. Now, so here instead of giving 10, I'll give 20, because while displaying also I gave what? 20. So just observe now. Yeah, when I say F8, I'll double click on 1002. Yeah, if you see V underscore Kunnar, I'm extracting what? 0 of 20. 0 in the from the system field SY-LICL. Starting from the index 0, I'm extracting 20 characters. I got 1002. I got 1002. Okay, rest of thing are what? Spaces. So if it is not initial, again I'm using unpack function. Again, it has suffixed only what? 6 zeros, because the overall width is what? Character of what? 10. I got the say, I'll get the sales orders. I got some 104. I'm able to display. So here, okay. So if I give 10 or 20, it is working fine. Okay, if I give 10 or 20, it's working fine. Done. But in both the cases, I must use what? Unpack function. Yeah. So Vamshi, I think you asked this only, no? Why we have to give 20? I can give 10 only, no? So I think it's working fine. It's working fine here. Whether I give 10 or 20, it is working fine. But in both the cases, I must use what? Unpack function, so that it is going to suffix that many number of zeros before this particular customer number. Okay, done. Anyway, we got this data. Now, when I double click on 1002, I got the sales orders. What is the next requirement here? Based, if I double click on this customer number, sorry, if I double click on the sales order, I have to get the sales item. So what is the logic I have to do here also? This is what list? Secondary list. Whenever I double click anywhere on the list, what happened? The same event is triggered at line selection. Here also same concept. The entire line content is stored in what field? SY-LI-SCL. But we are not interested in the entire line content. We are interested only in the Weblen part. In the Weblen part. So if you see the table also, if you see the table, in the table, yeah, Weblen also it is suffixed with what? Zeros. The width of Weblen is what? Character of 10. Here also suffixed with what? Zeros. But when it is displaying on the list, it is not showing the zeros, but internally it is stored as zeros followed by the value. So here also I can write the similar logic. What is that logic? What is the next index of the next available list? 2, na? So in the same event at line selection, I'll say when to, yeah, what I have to do now? Here I have to extract what? Sales document number from what? System field what? SY-LI-SCL. So I require one variable for storing the web length. I require one variable for storing the web length. So what I'll do in my include, I'll declare one web length somewhere here. I'll declare an individual field for referring to what? Web length. So I'll say VBAK-web length, which is character of what? 10. Let me activate this. Done. Go back. So here in the outline selection event, extract sales document number from the system field. So I'll say clear V underscore web length. V underscore web length is equal to what is this? SY-LI-SCL plus here also. What is the sequence of the fields I displayed? First web length, date, time, and what? Name of the person. We are interested only in the web length partner. What is the position of this web length? First field. What is the width? It is by default 0 of what? 10. So I'll say here also 0 of what? 10. So from the system field, it will extract the first 10 characters. So same logic. If V underscore web length is not initial, if it is not initial, what I have to do? I have to get the sales items for the selected, get the sales items for the selected sales document, for the selected sales document number. Done. So I need to call a subroutine, perform what? Get sales items. Already we know what is the relationship between VBAK and VBAP. Each sales order might contain 0 or 1 or more sales items, 0 or 1 or more sales items. I require what? Internal table. So let me declare the internal table. So here I'll declare the internal table for what? Sales items. So I'll say begin of TY underscore what? Sales items, same fields. What is the fields I want? Item number, then I want material number, then I want what? Net value. Here also I'll say what? PYSNR, material number, and then also what? NETWR, TY underscore sales items. Done. Then here I'll say T underscore what? Sales items. Here also I'll say sales items, and here also sales items. Let me activate my what is this? Acha, the table names is what? VBAP. Yeah, activate this include forcefully. This include is activated forcefully. Come back here. I need to define this subroutine. Perform get sales items. So does not exist. Create the object. Let me create that inside this include subdefinition. Done. Get the sales items. Select VBLN, item number, material number, net value from VBAP into table. What is the internal table? T underscore sales items. What is the common field between VBAK and VBAP? Web length equal to the selected web length. What is the selected web length? V underscore web length. Okay, understood. Here also the event triggered is what? Same event outline selection. The index of the next list is what? 2. So when 2? What I am doing here, I am extracting the sales document from the system field. Why I give 0 of 10? Because the position of this web length is what? First field only. Web length also, the width of web length is what? Character of 10. That's the reason I gave 0 of 10. Starting from the index 0, extract 10 characters. Based on the extracted sales document, we are getting the item data into the internal table. Then here I'll say if T underscore sales items is not blank, if it is not initial, what I have to do? Display what? Sales items. So I'll call one subroutine, perform display sales items. Perform display sales items. Else, I'll just give a message. No sales items for what? Selected sales document type what? Information message end if. So I need to define this subroutine for displaying the sales items. I'll double click on this, does not exist. I'll choose this. So we need to loop the internal table and display the data. So loop at T underscore sales items into work area is what? W underscore sales items end loop. Then I'll say write W underscore sales items hyphen hyphen what? Weblen. Item number, material number, and NETWR. So done. Activate this include program. Go back, activate this. Done. Similarly, I have to display some heading for this list now. What is the index of this list? 2. So how do we generate the index for the second list? Already we know we have to handle a event called as what? Top of page during line selection. So in the top of page during line selection, when 2, if it is secondary list 2, if it is secondary list 2, I'll say when 2, I'll give some heading sales items. For a basic list, the event is what? Top of page. For the secondary list, we can have up to what? 20 secondary list. So based on the index, I'm generating the heading for the secondary list. Okay, so when I execute, done. I'll double click on 1005, no sales orders for selected customer. I'll double click on 1002. These are the sales orders. Okay. Now if I double click anywhere on the line, okay, suppose if I double click on this 1035, what is the corresponding sales document? 5026. When I double click, no sales items for the selected sales document. Okay, I'll double click on 4997. No sales items for the selected sales document. But if you go and check the table, if you see the table, I'll go to what VBAP table, sales document item data. If you go to VBAP table, let me check whether the sales orders are having any sales items or not. For example, what is the sales number displayed here? 4997. 4997. So I'll go to VBAP table. I'll go, what is the field here? Weblen. The field is what? Weblen. Sales document number. I'll go to this 4997. Number of items, 4 items. Yes, we have the items for this particular sales document. 4997 has got what? Sales items. How many sales items? 4 sales items. Item number 10, 20, 30, 40. Okay, let me go back. I'll double click on 5055. Again, it is saying no sales item. But if you check the table, 5055 now. This also has got what? 4 items. Why? Because same issue. What is that? Here it is stored as what? Zeros followed by number. The width of the sales document is what? Character of 10. So here the problem is if you debug, I'll debug, just observe this. I'll put the breakpoint. I'll double click on 1002. Yeah, I'm not interested with this. I'll say F8. Done. Now I'll double click on 5055 anywhere on the line. Okay, or if I double click on this 1035, what is the corresponding sales document? 5026. I'll double click on this. Yeah, okay, F5. Control is going to when to. Done. So see here, SY-LI SCL contains the content of the entire line, but I'm interested only in the Weblen part. So when I extract that 0 of 10, I got 5026. I got 5026. If it is not initial, I'm trying to get the sales item. So if you see the internal table, it is initial. 5026, does it have any sales items? If you go to VBAP table, 5026, let me check it. 5026. Yes, it contains what? Sales items. How many sales items? 4 sales items. So, but here, since it is stored as what? 5026 in V underscore Weblen, my select will be failed. When I say F5, size of bars is what? 4, which indicates select is what? Failed. No data is retrieved. That's why I'm getting the message, no sales items. Because when it is displayed, it is not showing the zeros here. So that's why when you extract, you'll get only the 4 digits. So here also what I have to do, here also, before I get the sales items, I can use unpack function, or I can use that function model. Unpack what? v underscore wavelength to v underscore wavelength. So depending on the width of the variable, SAP will suffix that many number of what? Zeros. So when I execute now, observe now, I'll double click on 1002. Yeah, I'll double click on 5026. Yes, I got the sales items. I'll double click on 4997. Yes, I got the sales items. I'll double click on 5135. Yes, I got the sales items. Understood? Randomly, I'll double click. It has got only one item. Fine. This also has got only one item, but we are getting the item data. So, any questions so far? What is the next requirement now? If I double click on the material number, I should display the transaction MM03, and this selected material should come and sit in the field what? In the field material field in the transaction MM03. So I want to do one small change. So far, for interacting with this data, we are double clicking. We are double clicking anywhere on the list line. Now my customer wants, suppose here item data is spread. You don't want the double click. You want the hyperlink. So what I'll do here, okay, or else I'll cover that in the next scenario. Done. So now what is the requirement? When I double click on this material, it should display me the transaction what? MM03. So I have to extract the material number now. Why we require a material number? Suppose, let me run the T code. I am just independently going to run the T code what? MM03. What is this MM03? It is a standard transaction code provided by SAP for displaying the material data. So if you run this MM03, when I press enter, yes, it is displaying me the, it is going to display me the transaction code display material. So here it is asking what material number. Suppose I'll give some material number 100-100. This is one of the material number from MARA table, MARA table. So when I press enter here, it is asking me to select one of the view. I'll choose basic data one. When I continue, it is going to display me the material data. Let it display. It is displaying the material data. Understood? So what is my requirement now? When this T code is displayed, what are the selected material is there? It should come and sit in this particular field. So I should know the ID of this field. How to get the ID of this field from the transaction MM03? Put the cursor in this field. Press F1. There is a button. It is giving me some F1 help. In this F1 help, there is a button technical information. If I click on the technical information, what is the ID of this field? There is something called as parameter ID. What is the ID it is showing? MAT. The ID of that field it seems is what? MAT it seems. Okay. So I repeat, what is my requirement? Whenever the T code MM03 is displayed here, this selected material should come and sit in this particular field. For that purpose, I should know the ID of this field, parameter ID of that particular field. So when I press enter, right? So here I should know the name of this field. How to get the ID of this field? Put the cursor in that field. Press F1. When I press F1, you'll get the F1 help. In this, click on the button technical information. What is the parameter ID provided by SAP? Matt, it seems. Okay, so I collected the ID of that particular field. So now, what is the requirement now? What is the requirement now? When the item data is displayed, when the item data is displayed, when I double click on this, what is the event triggered again? At line selection. Again, the content of the entire line is stored in what field? SY-LI-SCL. From that SY-LI-SCL, I have to extract what field? Material number. I have to extract what? Material number. What is the position of this material number field? Third position. First is VBLN, sales document number, then item number, POSNR, and this is material number. So I have to extract the third field from that particular SY-LI-SCL. What is the after how many characters I have to extract? This is 10. The space of this webline is 10. The space of this what? NumC. What is that NumC? POSNR. So let me check the width of that. So in the VBAP table, if you go to VBAP table, yeah. What is this webline is what? Character of what? 10. POSNR is what? NumC of 6. The length is what? 6. Okay, so I have to leave this 16 spaces. I have to leave the first 16 characters. From the 17th character, I have to extract. From the 17th character, I have to extract. How many characters I have to extract? Material number width is what? 18, it seems. So from the 17th character, I have to extract how many characters? 18 characters. Okay. So what is the event triggered? At line selection. So in the same event at line selection, when one, when two, what is the index of the next list? Three, na? When three, when three, what I have to do now? What I have to do? Extract material number. Extract material number from what? System field SY-LI. SCL. So I require one field. I require one field for storing the material number. So I'll double click on this. So here I'll declare one field. So somewhere here I'll say data V underscore material number type VBAP hyphen material number. So I declared a variable type VBAP hyphen MATNR. Activate this include. Go back now. Yeah, now extract the material number. So I'll just clear that variable before I use that. V underscore material number. V underscore material number is equal to from the system field SY-LICL. I have to leave the first 16 characters because webland is character of 10. POSNR, sales document item number is 6. I have to leave the first 16 characters and start extracting from 17th character. How many characters I have to extract? What is the width of this material number? 18 characters. So I'll say index starts from 0. So starting from the index 16. Why I'm giving 16? Because the index starts from 0. If the index is starting from 1, I would have said 17. But since the index of the string starts from 0, I'm saying starting from the index 16. Index 16 means obviously character 17. Extract how many characters? 18 characters. Then I'll say if V underscore MATNR is not initial, if it is not blank, what I have to do? Display the transaction MM03 for displaying material content. For displaying the material content. So I'll simply say, how do you call any transaction? Call transaction. What is the T code I want to call? MM03. MM03 is a standard T code for what? Material display. I'm calling the transaction MM03 and if that's all. So as of now, I'm just calling the transaction. Let me check whether it works or not. Done. Execute this. 1002. I'll double click on 7354. I got only one item, one material. Okay, anywhere I can double click. I'll double click on M03. I got some other material. Previously I gave 100-100, but what should happen? This material should come and sit in this field. If I double click on M02, M02 should come here. Already we identified the ID of this field. What are the ID given by SAP MAT? So what I'll do before calling that particular transaction, we have one statement called as set parameter ID. What is the ID name? MAT. MAT field. Where is the selected metal available? Inside my variable V underscore MATNR. So I'll say V underscore MATNR. So before calling the transaction, I'm using the statement set parameter ID for associating the value for that particular field ID. Okay. So when I execute, let's see whether the selected metal is shown or not. So when I execute, I'll double click on 4997 M04. Yes, I got M04. But I got 0 bus. So when I press enter, it is saying that the material does not exist or is not activated. Okay, so we'll see what is the issue. I'll just go back M01. Again, and I'm getting 0. So somewhere the problem is there. So let us debug. I'll put the breakpoint. I'll double click on 1001. Okay, I'm not interested in this. I'll double click on 5196. I'm not interested in this. I got 2 materials. Now I'll double click on L40F. Done. I'm interested in this. F5. Control goes to Win3. Yeah, if you see this, SY-LISCL, this is the entire line content, but I am interested only in this L40F. So if you see material number, what is the logic I wrote? Starting from the index 16, extract what? 18 characters. So why I guess 16? Because I know that material number is character of 10. NumC is what? 6 characters. I left 16 characters and I want to extract from 17th character. Since the index starts from 0, I am getting 16. But let me check what is happening in MATNR. When I say F5, good. I got 0. So I am getting from here, boss. I should get from here. So why like that? That is the issue. Okay, that's why it is shown there. So what I'll do now is, when I go to this, for this webline, it is showing it as character of 10. It is showing it as what? Character of 10. Okay. So if I double click on this data element, this data element is having what domain? Webline character of 10. Let me double click on the domain. What is the output length here? 10 it seems. Output length is 10. Fine. I'll just go back. I'll double click on PYSNR. It is showing it as NumC of 6. It is not character of 6. It is NumC of 6. Alpha numeric of what? 6. Let me double click on the data element. Okay. Done. This is my domain for that particular data element. Let me double click on the domain. Output length is again 6 only. But it is occupying more this thing. I'll go back. Character of 18. How do we understand this? Output length, it is showing 6 only, but it is occupying more. Yes, any suggestion what could be the reason? I thought output length is more, but still output length is 6 only. One second. NumC is a numeric text length m. How do we understand this? Let me double click on this M15. I may get the runtime error. Yes, it cannot be interpreted as a number, it is having zero. No. If you see SY-LICL, you design this much data. Why I'm getting zero? That is the issue. Okay, I'll do one small change. The change I'll do is, let me declare one variable for item number also. Data v underscore pysnr type vbap-pysnr. year v underscore Veblen v underscore QSNR. So I'll say v underscore Veblen is equal to SY hyphen LI SEL plus, we know that Veblen is character of 10, so I'll say 0 of what 10, then v underscore PYSNR is equal to SY hyphen LI SEL plus, starting from the index what 10, because the index starts from what 0, so starting from the index 10 extract what 6 characters. Done. Starting from the index 10, extract 6 characters. Done. Okay, let me just put the breakpoints here. I'll double click on M18. Yeah. So if you see SY-LISCL, this is the entire line, and if you observe Veblen, PUSNR and material number, done FI, done. I'm clearing those values, done. Yeah, I'm extracting the first 10 characters. Done, I got it. Then I'm saying PUSNR. What is the PUSNR here? 4 zeros followed by 20. FI, that is the problem. Yeah, that is a problem. See, actually, if you see PUSNR, I'm expecting this value, but why I got this value? Yes, anyone, what could be the issue? 0 of 10. Starting from the index 0, extract 10 characters.
I think it should be 11 of 6 and 17 of 18.
Why 11 of 6? Why 11 of 6? 11 means index becomes 11th index.
Yeah, 11.
But index starts from 0 only, no? The index of the string starts from 0 only. What they are saying is the index starts at 1. Is the index starts from 1 or 0? I'm using SIFN LISL. V underscore pipeline is 5026. V underscore PYSNR is, this is fine now. Material number is what? M15. But again, I got space here. I got space. See, the material M15 does not exist. I should remove the space here. But I think the index starts from 0 only. Why we have to give 1?
Maybe
yes, Raghav.
So maybe data issue.
No, it's not data issue. I'm still in confusion whether the index starts from 0 or 1. I believe index starts from 0 only. Anyone, Rajesh, Vamshi, index starts from 0 or 1 in ABAP?
1, sir.
1, na? Sure?
Yeah, I feel 1.
Okay, if that is the case, then I need to modify here also, no? I have to give 1 of 20. Here also I have to give 1 of 10. Here I don't require this. So then this should be 17 of 18. Why I got like this? No sales order for selected customer. Okay. That V underscore Kunna. See, Rajesh, I gave 1 of 20.
Yeah, I think 0 then.
Then 0. So it should be 0 only. Okay, let me check what is the issue. So 0 of 20. Here also 0 of 10. I'm sure what I find the index at 0. But how it is logically correct? When the first index starts from 0, we have to go by that width only. No? Here also I should be 16 of 18. Because 0 to 9 is what? 0 to 9 is sales document. And from 10 to 15 is POSNR. And 16 to so and so is what? Material number.
Sir, once I got the similar error, what I did is like I converted, assigned that to a string variable. Then again, I think it was working fine for me at that time.
which one you converted to string?
That SY hyphen line selection was there, right? This one.
This
I have assigned
one.
this to string.
No, no, this is anyway, it's a string only, no? SY hyphen LISCL, it's a what character of 255. It's a string only. Why we need to convert? And you not convert. Since it is string only, I am able to use this offset logic. Otherwise, we cannot use. Okay, we'll check what is the issue. I'm getting late for other class. So I'll just park this aside. So as of now, what we have done is we are able to do this. Done. When I double click on the material, I got it, but this should be remote. I should get only M03. So I'll address that point in the next class. So if I give M03 only, when I press enter, yes, I got this. I'll choose basic data one. I got the content. Okay. So in the next class, what we'll do is we'll address this problem. And also, so far, we are identifying the selected content by referring to the system field what SY-LISCL. There are other two ways to identify the selected content. That is, one is using by using id statement, and another is by using get cursor statement. So what we need to do is I'll copy this program to the other program. Then instead of referring to the system field, we'll use other two techniques. But all of you, please try this issue. Okay. Whatever I understand is index always starts from zero only. But why we have to add? Why we have to add? That is what is my question. Manika, why we have to add? No, why? You are trying to achieve the output. Okay. If I say 18 of 18, I will get it. So by seeing the error, you are saying 18 of 18. But if you go by the width part, it is 0 to 9 and 15 to 6 only. Now 10 to 15. If I give 18 of 18, yes, I would get the results. But our agenda is not to achieve the result. Okay, we have to go by the width stored in the database. Yeah, this will come now. But by seeing the error, we are doing that. But why I have to give 18 of 18? You have to go by logical sense. Na? Weblen is character of 10 and PYSNR is 10 spaces. So I should go by that calculation. Okay, so we'll see what is the point behind that. Definitely, there should be some reason behind that. So why we have to go for the 18 of 18? We should not go for 18 of 18. We should go by this only. But somewhere, we should check how much width that NEMC is occupying. That is what is the agenda. But when I check the documentation there in the output length also, see here, that's what I check this. If you see this, if you see this domain, output length, they're showing it as 6 only. If they would have set it as 8, then I would have been 18 of 18, but they gave it a 6 only. So I'll check what is the reason behind this. You also check that. I hope it's clear to everyone.
Okay.
Yeah. So next class, we'll have it on Monday. Tomorrow I'm not available. We'll have it on Monday and we'll address this issue and we'll see the other two techniques to identify the selected value. Right, all of you just check this issue. What is the reason why it is not recognizing this index position? Okay. So next CoreWeb class, we'll have it on Monday. Okay, tomorrow and after tomorrow, no CoreWeb class. We'll have it on Monday only. Chalo.